In last two parts of EDIMA, we have seen general introduction, types, components behind the mechanism of EDIMA and pathogenesis regarding EDIMA. So in this part and the next part, we will discuss about certain types of EDIMA and the clinical conditions which will be coming under that particular kind of EDIMA and the peculiar feature of that EDIMA also. Certain examples of disseminated edema. Disseminated edema, which means the type of edema which will spread throughout the body from a localized region or from a generalized region or from a regionalized region, it will spread throughout the body. So edema due to cardiac failure, with respect to congestive cardiac failure, congenital heart disorders also, ischemic heart diseases, proper blood circulation will not be happening. This will cause certain invariability with respect to pressure variance, hydrostatic pressure and the oncotic pressure. This will cause edema. So because of the cardiac failure. Nephritic and nephrotic edema. With respect to the nephrons, with respect to the kidney, as a whole kidney itself, or the whole malfunctioning of the kidney itself, edema will be forming because of the sodium and water retention. That will be termed as nephritic edema. Complications or some kind of disturbances with respect to the nephrons, along with as a whole disturbances will be happening to the kidney or renal system itself. Edema caused by liver failure as a co-component, any kind of abnormality or some kind of pathology is affected with the liver itself. There will be splenomegaly condition also. There will be hepatomegaly condition also. This will act as the further secondary cause for formation of edema. Nutritional edema, inadequate intake of proper nutrients or the lack of intake of proper nutrient supply to the body will cause edema. Specifically, fetal edema will be occurring there. Protein loss through gastrointestinal system. We have seen already albumin, we can consider as the main most or foremost component behind fluid and the water retention along with the fluid balance. So whenever the albumin loss is more through the gastrointestinal system, which means through the stool, much evacuation of stool will be there. Along with the stool, more protein loss, that is albumin loss, is present. This will cause disseminated edema. Edema due to endocrine pathologies with respect to the RAS mechanism, renin, angiotensin, aldosterone system also we should consider here. Why? Because whenever these kind of pressure variance, hydrostatic pressure and the imbalance between the oncotic pressure is happening, the kidney or the system related to the kidney will be maintaining with this kind of fluid imbalance. So wherever the endocrine gland which is not acting properly or any kind of hormonal imbalance also present there as a result of some other systemic disorders also, this will cause disseminated edema. During the time of pregnancy also we can see disseminated type of edema because of the hemodilution or the more condition with respect to the hemoconcentration also. Certain edema we will see, or certain explanation regarding the further types of edema we will see in these slides. Cardiac insufficiency because of the cardiac failure. Blood volume per minute decreases, that will be the cause. Water is conserved by renal and hormonal mechanisms. So hydrostatic pressure will be increased there because of the cardiac failure or because of cardiac insufficiency. Lack of proper cardiac output is present. Because of this, this will be causing water is conserved by renal and hormonal mechanisms. This will cause hydrostatic pressure increased. Nephritic edema. Mild and hard edema is seen in acute glomerulonephritis condition. The inflammation with respect to the glomerulus, that is along with the nephrons also, that is acute glomerulonephritis condition. This will be mild and sometimes it will be hard also will present. Glomerular filtration decreases but tubular reabsorption is not disturbed. That is a glomerulotubular imbalance. So glomerular filtration always will be in a state of decreasing, but with respect to tubular reabsorption, this will not be hampered. So the condition glomerulotubular imbalance also we can consider here. with respect to the glomerulus, with respect to the tubular reabsorption. Capillaritis, generalized capillary disorder, we can consider here also. Generalized capillary disorder with respect to the capillaries associated with the fluid retention along with the urine reabsorption and secretion mechanism. Nephritic edema, we finish. Here it is nephrotic edema. It is very soft and in Anasarca type. Generalized type we can find out here. Low oncotic pressure due to protein loss. Because of if more protein loss is happening, there will be low oncotic pressure will be happening. This will cause secondary hyperaldosteronism condition. One more endocrinological disorder also will be manifesting there. That is secondary hyperaldosteronism because of the more secretion of aldosterone hormone with respect to the kidney. Cirrhotic edema, it is usually seen with the ascites condition. Albumin synthesis in liver decreases. Whenever production of albumin is decreased in liver itself, this will cause cirrhotic type of edema. With respect to the ascites condition, ascites condition, it is termed as fluid accumulation with respect to the abdominal region or abdominal cavities. Some blood proteins are excreted in pieces due to portal hypertension. So as a result of hypertension occurring with respect to portal veins, blood proteins will be excreted in the feces. So whenever aldosterone breakdown in liver decreases, secreted by adrenal gland increases. This is called again secondary hyperaldosteronism. So the aldosterone hormone which will break down in liver decreases. So with respect to the liver, there will be breakdown of aldosterone happening. This gradually will be decreasing and secretion by adrenal gland increases as a resultant of this. Nutritional type of edema. Kwashiorkor is one type of nutritional disease along with malabsorption syndrome also will be there. With respect to kwashiorkor and with respect to malabsorption syndrome, proper amount of protein or energy will not be supplied there. Because of that, protein or the other nutrients will not be supplied to the person. As a result of that, body will not be getting proper amount of protein or energy. This will cause nutritional type of edema, other category of edema. Edema due to endocrine pathologies. Myxoedema, premenstrual edema, pregnancy with respect to endocrine glands. As a result of thyroid imbalance, hypothyroidism or hyperthyroidism. Hyperthyroidism condition, myxoedema type of conditions will be present along with the edema of the eyeballs or isosceles. Premenstrual edema as a condition where it will be affecting with the premenstrual stage, edema will be forming with respect to the women. Pregnancy condition also, edema will be forming as a result of some kind of pathologies or hormonal imbalances happening with respect to the endocrine glands. Iatrogenic, we have already seen iatrogenic, which means as a result of, as a fault of surgery or radiation therapy. So mineralocorticoid, corticosteroid, androgen, antidiuretic hormone related hormones will be acting more in case of iatrogenic edema. As a result of this, what will be there? Certain kind of hormonal imbalance also will happen, and according to that, edema will be forming in our body. So because of certain kind of surgery, because of certain kind of radiation, and as a result of some complications from medicines also. If you are taking some medicines for the condition or to treat some other systemic or metabolic disorders, as a result of complication from that medicines also, iatrogenic edema can be happen. So this will cause some kind of imbalance or hampering in between the normal mechanism of endocrine activities. We will continue the further types of disseminated edema and the other types of edema also in upcoming part.